Hey love, welcome back to my channel. I am so excited to be bringing you this tutorial. I think I have to say that it was the most fun and different and creative tutorial that I've done. Like, I'm so excited at how the results came out, and can I just say, wow, as far as like the lush moisture that this imparts into my hair, both the rose and the henna work amazingly. I have to say though that the rose does give the hair a slight reddish hue and the henna does give the hair a slight brownish hue. And if that's not something you're interested in, maybe you might want to substitute and use amla instead, but I had amazing results with using these, and I am using these as a treatment in my hair before going on vacation. And I think that this is going to be an absolute staple as we approach winter time. I know it's about to be fall, guys, isn't that crazy? But it's going to be an absolute staple. You can use this, literally you can use one of the henna ones, which is quite small. You could probably use that as a gloss addition. If you're interested in seeing how I apply these and how I use these, please let me know below. But you basically need to double boil it, so you need to heat it up. Some people might prefer to use a microwave. I prefer to put a bowl over a pot in hot water and melt it down, and then you can add your deep conditioner to that, or you can use your avocado, or you could use whatever it is that you enjoy adding to your deep conditioners or using as your deep conditioner. As long as it's moisturizing, you can add it and then place that in your hair. I actually let it sit in my hair for probably about 4 hours and then I rinse it out. You may wish to follow up with a moisturizing deep conditioner. I actually just used a moisturizing deep conditioner as a co-wash to make sure that I got all the residue of the product out of my hair. All of these herbs, they do tend to stay in the hair. Yeah, they get quite attached, so it might be an idea. But can I just say, hydration, just another level. Like, literally, you know when you can feel the moisture, you know when you put shea butter in your hair and it's just like velvet to touch? Yeah, that's basically what this deep conditioner is. It really does help me out and it really does support my channel and let YouTube know that this content is worthwhile and worth promoting. So if you could give my video a thumbs up, it helps me the most. Honestly, it really does. And it also lets me know this is the kind of thing that you're interested in. Please comment below if you're going to be trying this or if you have tried a gloss bar before. But basically, we got creative with a gloss bar and did cake pops and rose-shaped molds, and wait till you see how easy it was to create. Okay, love, so you need 4.5 tablespoons of cocoa butter. This is super strengthening and moisturizing, and it actually prevents hair breakage because it's giving that extra amazing moisture, like seriously. And then you want 7 tablespoons of coconut oil, which is packing omega fats, lauric acids, antioxidants. It prevents protein loss from the hair, and it prevents the hair from snapping when it is wet, which is really, really important. If you're intolerant of coconut oil, you can always substitute it for something else, but make sure you up your cocoa butter. Next, you want 1 tablespoon of honey. You can substitute this with glycerin or even marshmallow root, but raw honey contains enzymes and it's an emollient, and it reduces breakage, and it's rich in antioxidants, has antibacterial properties, and it's super soothing for the scalp and very hydrating. Next, I grabbed Slipery Elm and Aloe Vera powder, two of my favorite ingredients. The Aloe Vera gives a balance of the pH. They both add slip to the hair. And then I go in with my henna. Now, henna is actually a really powerful ingredient. It fills in like any crevices of damage in the hair. It's super strengthening, really nourishing. It's been one of my ride or die favorites forever, but it can tint the hair. So if you don't want to tint your hair, go for cassia as opposed to using henna. Now here you can see, so the oils have all been melted down and I've added all my powders. Now it's simply just a case of mixing this, and by the way, can I just say, it smells like chocolate. It smells amazing, and it actually ends up looking like chocolate, I guess, as well. But the fact that you've got the cocoa butter and the coconut oil in combination, girl, let me tell you.
And so, okay, so you can be as fun as you like with this. You can just use like polystyrene cups, or you could use ice cube trays. But you know me, I am extra as anything. So I've got these really fun cake molds from Amazon. These are cake pops. And so all you do is you grab a funnel and you fill it in, and yeah, you pretty much end up with something that looks like candy. Next, I grab my ingredients again. I'm basically going to be repeating the recipe to make the to make the rose gloss bars, but this time I'm going to be using shea butter to substitute for the coconut oil, and I'm also going to be using rose powder as opposed to henna, but the rest of the ingredients completely the same, and I'm going to be leaving them in the description box below. Now if you if you want to make sure that it stays solid at room temperature, depending on what your local temperature is like, you might decide that you just want to use shea butter in either of these recipes, or you might have to make it like mostly cocoa butter. So have a little bit of a play. It's such a fun item to give to a girlfriend who's really into natural hair, and I think it would be great as like a Christmas or Thanksgiving gift. So here I go again with my extra self. These are gorgeous silicone rose shaped molds, which I got from Amazon again. I'm gonna see if I can find the link to put it below this video if I can. And I just fill this up with my mixture. And honestly, I love these molds. They make all the difference, especially if you're going to be gifting them to somebody. Then all you have to do is you have to pop it into the freezer. I try and normally put it in overnight, but at the very least, you want to put it in for 5 to 6 hours to make sure that it solidifies. Next, you just want to remove them from their molds. Aren't they gorgeous? I absolutely adore this. I adore this method. As I say, you can actually add one of these to your regular conditioner after you melt it down. You can do that with either of these, and it just gives any conditioner the most amazing boost. And it's very similar to the sort of treatments that you can buy from Lush, which are, you know, amazing actually. So I love the fact that these are just the right size for if you wanted to actually do a gloss. Here are my cake pops. I was really, really excited to open these up. Note to you guys, use plastic straws for this. I just put in a paper straw to show you. It's pretty weak sauce and it does actually fall apart at the neck. So I strongly recommend that you get those more sturdy, like plastic solid straws that you can get again from Amazon. So these are our results. I absolutely loved it. It was so, so fun. And if it's winter time, they should stay solid. But as I say, you might have to figure out what ratios work for the temperature where you are.
So don't forget that I'm doing my 100K giveaway, which I'm going to announce the winners of at the end of this month. So being the last day of August, I'm going to be announcing my winners. If you're interested in participating, all you have to do is be a subscriber. So if you're not already subscribed, please subscribe to my channel. I'm going to be giving away 2 bundles here on my YouTube channel, and that includes some NYX lingerie lipstick, that includes NYX Away We Glow, it includes some of their eyeshadow palettes. I'm also going to be giving away Buclem travel kits with a curl definer, deep conditioner, curl cream, 2 packs of those for each winner. They're slightly different packs. And I'm also going to be giving away $65 worth of Bell Bar Organics vouchers. So you can pick up whatever you love from Bell Bar Organics. They do stuff that is not affiliated with me as well. They do like face masks, they do scrubs, which are to die for, which have been amazing in my skincare routine. So please be sure to simply subscribe to enter. Over my Instagram, just look out for the posts that I'm going to be doing on my Instagram. If you're not already following me over there, make sure you do so. So guys, thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Please, 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 could you do me a favor? You might have heard about the disastrous floods that happened in Sierra Leone. I started up a GoFundMe page because I want to do some work out there, and I want to help people that have been devastated by this disaster. So please check out the link below. And even if it's just a dollar, if everyone watched this video gave a dollar, we would surpass our target. So also, can I just say a massive thank you to all of your love on the hair growth oil that we released. The feedback on this has been phenomenal.
If you missed my last video, we've actually released that DIY hair growth oil, which you guys have been loving and asking for the longest time. The link for that is going to be below this video as well. I hope to see you in the next video. I'm going to be releasing the New York oil. Well, what am I even talking about? I'm going to be releasing the New York meet and greet oil launch vlog. I'm so excited, guys. I really, really would appreciate your support on that and a thumbs up to this video as well. Yes, Bell Bar is going to have a pop-up at Afropunk and at Black Girl Beauty. Details are going to be in the description box.
Before you came round, my heart would never be much faster. Before you came round, I was ready to slow down. Before you came round, I was heading for a small disaster. Before you came round, I was ready to blow me down.